Here on. I'm sorry.
Hey, how are you all doing today?
Hey, just fine.
What do I believe and why? I believe in pantheism. I've called in like a couple times before. I talked with Jim there. You know, we had a little chat on the and Messenger and stuff like that. But suffice it to say, I see an order and elegance in the universe and a clear design from my perspective. You know, you all were talking about evolution and DNA. Wouldn't you say DNA is directly tied to evolution, right?
Yes.
Hey, I'd like to get into the watchmaker fallacy for a brief second. Now, if you have a watch like DNA,
you can just say watchmaker argument, and I know exactly what you're talking about. We don't need necessarily go into it, but here's the question: how do you determine what is a reliable method? Let me go back. I've got two trees. One tree, I tell you, is created. The other tree is natural. Nobody's ever seen these trees before. How do you determine the natural one from the created one? Then they look exactly the same, but nobody's seen these trees. How do you go about determining which one is created and which one is natural?
As far as that goes, you wouldn't be able to distinguish that, I wouldn't believe, but...
That's the problem with the watchmaker argument. We're very, very... We humans are very, very bad at figuring out what is natural and what is created. Unless we know specifically that something was created when it comes to watches, when it comes to art, when it comes to all the things, all the examples people use for the watchmaker argument, we know what those are. And there's a set of so-called steps off the coast of Japan that a scuba diver found, and he swears up and down that these are steps for giants. And geologists say, no, they're not. They're naturally occurring formations. We're really, really bad at determining design from things when we don't know. And not only are we really bad at it, but we're also very prone to seeing something and then seeing that as a pattern and assuming that the pattern is true.
How does that relate to... Let's move on beyond that. The watchmaker fallacy I have problems with, but we apparently don't have enough time for that. My God would be a natural God as a pantheist. There's nothing supernatural about the universe. It's all natural.
Then what's the point of your God? Then what's the point of your God?
Why do you need a God, Patrick? Why can't there just be nature?
There has to be a point to a God. Why does there need to be a point to a God? Why does a God need to serve you? Why do you need to get special? It's a reverence for it is what I have. Like Einstein, he said, you know, the music of spheres. You know, he said straight up, I'm not an atheist. Some atheists appear to want to put Einstein as an atheist, but he clearly said he was a pantheist.
He didn't say that. He said if he had to choose, he would be a theist in the same. He'd believe in Spinoza's God, which is basically pantheism. But he said more times that he didn't believe in a God than he has said he believes in the God of Spinoza. So that's just simply not the case.
Explain that to Taku, because Mikhail Taku was explaining that he's got a YouTube video about the God of Einstein. So.
Yes, he does. And he's talking about, yes. Why
does it matter to me what Einstein thought? I don't follow Einstein. And you seem to feel like you need to attach the, you're not listening, Patrick, we can't both talk at the same time. You say that you want to attach some God to the nature around you and that you want to believe in that God being that, why does there need to be a God of any kind in your world?
Well, I would ask you the same question. Why does there need to be an absence of a God? Same question.
Because there's no evidence for a God.
That's why.
No evidence. Okay. Evidence, something outside of our universe with science. Science doesn't go there.
No, I'm talking about the world that we know and the world that we see. I don't see evidence. I don't see evidence for I don't see evidence for a God.
Right.
So Patrick, therefore, I don't feel the need to attach.
Let's get into this. How do you ask for evidence? What would you say would be evidence of a God? You would say that's dependent upon the God claim, right?
When you make a claim that there's a God, then I say, show me evidence. That's that simple. Don't make it complicated.
Consider evidence of God.
What?
That I've never had an atheist answer that question, ever.
What's the question?
Because we don't.
What would you consider evidence?
Well, so there's a problem with the question, and the problem is
anything that
we don't know what it would take because we haven't seen the correct evidence. But this is also why a prosecutor is not allowed to ask a jury, what evidence would it take for you to convict the defendant? You don't do that. You've got to present the evidence and evaluate it. And no evidence for the evidence presented for any God so far has failed to meet its burden of proof.
The evidence is based on the claim. The evidence is based on the claim. When you make a claim of such and such God, then you need evidence to back up that claim. Because to throw out the term God is so nebulous and vague that it doesn't even have a definition. So when you throw out a claim that I'm defining God as blank, then there needs to be evidence to support that claim. It's that simple.
If you can define what you would consider evidence, maybe.
No, you define the God first.
Define the God, present your evidence, we'll decide if it meets our burden of proof or not. That's the way it works.
As far as I believe, so what would you consider evidence for that?
No, you keep asking the same question, and the answer
right.
is still the
and,
same.
Yeah, the answer is still the same, and we will talk to you next time. Have a nice evening. Bye-bye. And that was...
What would it take for you to believe? Depends on the claim you're making.
Yeah, it actually absolutely does. If you're making a claim the sky is blue, we don't need as much evidence for that. But if you claim that some guy rose from the dead, we're going to need a lot more evidence for that claim. Extraordinary claims require extraordinary evidence. It's not my fault you don't understand how evidence works. So anyway.